and Merry Christmas. Welcome to our United Christmas Liturgies for Saints Patrick and Andrew and All Saints. We are so glad you have chosen to celebrate the joy of Christmas with us today. As we prepare the way of our hearts for the coming of the Christ Child, we invite you to join in singing, O Little Town of Bethlehem, found on the first page of your program.
Thank you.
join in singing What Child Is This?, which can be found on the first page of your program.
Thank you.
During our next song, families and individuals will be bringing forth the figures of our nativity scene. We invite you to join in singing the refrain. The words are very simple. Alleluia, alleluia. Procession and to remain at the Nativity scene while Father Tim blesses it. At this time, all children are invited to the back of church. Oh, excuse me, I'm sorry, we changed that. All children are invited to come forward to the front of church to place their straw over in the manger, where Father Tim will greet the children and bless the manger scene.
Cell phones or electronic devices that you may have
so there is no interference with our live streaming efforts. We are so glad that all of you are here. We hope that you received a program which will help you participate in our liturgy. We invite you to join wholeheartedly in our songs and in our prayers. As we begin our celebration of the joy of Christmas, please stand now and greet those who have gathered to worship with us today.
And we continue with our celebration this afternoon. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And the Lord be with you. As we begin our celebration today, first of all, a word of welcome to all, and a special word of thanks to our young choir who have been practicing week after week after week, who did such a beautiful prelude. A word of thanks to Sister Marcia for her work with them. Can you join me now in thanking our young people and all those who have particular word of thanks to all the families who joined us today in bringing up the nativity scene characters. A particular word of thanks to Don Cromer, one of the senior members of our parish, St. Patrick and Andrew, who carried in baby Jesus in our procession today. Word of thanks to all who had a role and participated today. As we gather, let's do what we do well, and that is recall how generous and how good our God is. He loved us so much that he sent his only Son to bring us mercy and healing. Let's be mindful of our faults and our failings and our need for God's mercy.
Lord Jesus, you fill us with joy by your birth among us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come for all people. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Savior of the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of any of our sins, and bring each one of us to life everlasting. O God, who gladden us year by year as we wait in hope for our redemption, grant that just as we joyfully welcome your only begotten Son as our Redeemer, we may also merit to to face him confidently when he comes again as our judge. For he lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet. Until her vindication shines forth like a dawn, and her victory like a burning torch. Nations shall behold your vindication, and all the kings your glory. You shall be called by a new name, pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of your Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken or your land desolate, but you shall be called my delight, and your land espoused. For the Lord delights in you and makes the land his spouse. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder shall marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. God of whose people Israel chose our ancestors, exalted the people during their sojourn in the land of Egypt. With uplifted arm, he led them out of it. Then he removed Saul and raised up David, his king. Of him he testified, I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. He will carry out my every wish. From this man's descendants, God, according to his promise, has brought to Israel the Savior Jesus. Down Herod is coming by proclaiming the baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. And as John was completing his course, he would say, what do you suppose that I am not here? Behold, one is coming after me. I am not worthy to fasten the sandals of his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
You were afraid I was going to preach too long and you couldn't stand there the whole time, is that it? Young people, so nice to see the young people at this 4 o'clock Mass being our primary ministers, reading and singing our way through this wonderful Christmas liturgy. But you're young people. You're not babies. And Christmas Eve, the stories are about a baby. Now, I'd much rather have young people's stories, because you guys, you're not quite as messy as babies. Babies, I understand, get awful messy. And just as soon as you get them cleaned up, you know what happens? They get messy again. Now, I don't have any babies, never had any babies, and kind of glad I don't have any babies, because I understand babies are needy and clingy and crying and messy sometimes. Here we are at the 4 o'clock Mass. The 4 o'clock Mass on Christmas Eve. It's the biggest Mass in any Catholic parish the world over. People pack in at 4 o'clock. Everybody seems to want that early Mass. Places are packed. Parking lots are crazy. People parked on every street corner you can imagine. If we're not knee-deep in snow or frozen ice underneath our feet, it's pouring down rain with threats of wind. While children wait with anticipation for the sound of reindeer hooves and sleigh bells, parents are yelling and screaming, trying to get them dressed on time, trying to get here on time. There's anger flaring up on street corners and in parking lots. The 4 o'clock Mass. One priest said, it's the yearly reason people remember why they don't do this all the time. 4 o'clock Mass, we pack them in. Some people may be here a little bit reluctantly. Some people may have been coaxed here or forced here from familiar places where we usually had 4 o'clock Mass. Some people are coaxed here and a little uncertain about this new technology, live streaming. What? Why do we have to be here? Why did we have to be in here? I told you we should have left earlier. People here, 4 o'clock Mass, packed in shoulder to shoulder, some reluctantly, some reminded of the changing times and a changing church. And we come in here and we hear baby stories. We hear messy stories. And trust me, the story of Jesus is about as messy as it comes. She wasn't married. They hadn't been together. He was a little upset and he was distrusting. Could have divorced her, could have had her stoned, in fact, but decided he'd listen to an angel instead. And as we read the collection of stories, they get even messier. They couldn't even stay in Nazareth. Maybe they were even glad to get the heck out of Nazareth where all the gossip was flying. But they had to be in Bethlehem, a strange city where they didn't have reservations and where there wasn't any room. And the only room they had was in the stable. And the only place for their baby was not a crib, but a manger, an animal trough. And let's not forget, as the story unfolds, there's Herod. What a nasty piece of work and what a nasty part of the story. Didn't turn out so good for Jesus' neighbors and cousins. Herod was mad. He showed his anger. It's a messy story, these baby stories of Jesus. I'd rather read Mark's gospel, or I'd rather read John's gospel. Start off with some pretty poetry and then jump right into Jesus in the River Jordan, starting his ministry, starting his teachings about loving folks, even loving your enemies, starting his teaching about forgiving folks, forgiving everybody, starting his teaching where he overturns tables in the temple and where he gets all the high priests and all the churchy people all uppity. And he scolds them for being too churchy, for not being holy, for not being human, for not being kind, for not being just. I just as soon jump into the adult stories of Jesus, because babies, they're messy. I talked to some parents recently. Jackie and Andy. They have a brand new baby, Thomas. It's their first. And they're all excited, and they're the best parents. They sat in at baptism class, and they took turns holding him and rocking him, and he was the best baby. He didn't fuss at all. But they told me that their lives are forever changed. Nothing's the same anymore in their household now that this baby's here. They don't sleep the whole night anymore. Babies cry and demand things of us at times when it's inconvenient, like at 2 o'clock in the morning, they tell me. They said the things that used to be important in their lives aren't important anymore. Their lives have been transformed all because of a baby. And then there was Ryan and Chrissy. Now they're having a baby. They already have 2 children. Their children are in junior high. They're about the business of being junior high parents, coaching basketball and softball and those things. And guess what? Now they're having a baby. Things are going to be different in their house, let me tell you. Not only are they going to be junior high parents, they're going to be infant parents as well. And then I talked to Sean and Kelly, and they had their new little baby Roman there first. They were all excited. They were in church just a couple of weeks ago, their first time being in church since the baby was born. And Kelly said, "Father, it's the first time we've been on time for anything," she said. She said, "We're late for everything. You have no idea how long it takes to get a child around. And just when you think the child is all around and ready, guess what? It needs to be changed again." She said, "We're sometimes an hour late for things." I talked to parents who have babies, and they remind me that babies turn our lives upside down. The babies are demanding. The babies are needy. The babies require our constant attention. And so here we are on Christmas Eve, packed into this place, and we hear stories about babies. And maybe, just maybe, we tell baby stories to remind us that Jesus needs our attention. That like a tiny child requires our attention, so too our relationship with Jesus requires our attention. Not just sometimes, not just once or twice a year, but daily, always, often in the day. Jesus requires us to be in a living relationship with him. You know what I think? I think babies teach us. Babies teach us about communion. They teach us what it means to be intimately connected to one another. And every time we come in this church, do you know, we celebrate Holy Communion. That's what we celebrate. You folks who are over there in the parish hall and you're scratching your heads and you're wondering, like, why are we over here watching it on a big TV? Why don't we just stay at home? We could have just watched it on EWTN. But you know what? You don't get Holy Communion on EWTN. Our faith is personal, but it's not private. Our faith, the business of being church, requires that we do it with others. We don't do it at home on our own. We're in this together. Babies teach us. We're in this thing together. And then there's no just putting them aside for a while and separating ourselves from them. They need us always. And church needs you always. We need each other always. We need Jesus always. God could have done anything God wanted to show his love for us, anything he wanted to save us. But he decided to become a living, breathing human being so that we could have this understanding of our God with us, in relationship with us, in intimacy with us, in communion with us. So we celebrate here tonight at 4 o'clock what we can't get anyplace else. Not anyplace else in the world. We celebrate Holy Communion. This understanding that we have a God who wants us to hold him. Who wants us to be whole him. Who wants us to be one with him as he is with us. babies. They require our attention. They let us know when it's time to pay attention. And so it's good on Christmas Eve that we hear baby stories about a God who loves us so much and wants our undivided attention. Sisters and brothers, let's stand. Together, let's profess the faith of our baptism. As together we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day He arose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Now we lift up the evening prayers of the Church.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For our Catholic Church, may we always be filled with joy and live our faith as Jesus lived it, in our prayer, our work, and our play. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all Christians, may we learn from Jesus, who was kind and forgiving. May we treat our family members and friends as Jesus taught us. We pray to the Lord. For all who are sad at this time, and for all who are poor, may the story of Jesus comfort them and give them hope. We pray to the Lord. For those who are sick, may the Christmas story assure them that God is present in their midst and will never abandon them. We pray to the Lord. For all of us gathered here, may we be like angels, shepherds, and wise people who heard God's word and live it in their daily lives. We pray to the Lord. For our parish family, on this joyous eve of Christmas, we pray to the Lord. For the needs which we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Good and gracious God, in your great love for us, you sent us your only Son, Jesus, to teach us and save us and love us. Listen to our evening prayer. In your kindness, give to us all that we truly need, and in your great mercy, take from us, we beg, what hinders our knowing, loving, and serving you. For you live and you reign forever and ever.
Thank you. Thank you.
brothers and sisters. Pray now that my sacrifice and yours might be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we look forward, O Lord, to the coming festivities, may we serve you all the more eagerly, for knowing that in them you make manifest the beginnings of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in the love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat, drink it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, who is our Pope, with Daniel Thomas, our Bishop, with the clergy and religious, and with all the men and all the women who so faithfully serve your church. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may bear to be called heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you. proclaim.
Thank you. body of Christ.
Found on page 7 of your program.
Body of Christ.
Thank you.
And let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may draw new vigor from celebrating the nativity of your only begotten Son, by whose heavenly mystery we receive both food and drink. For he lives and reigns forever and ever. We do have just a few announcements before we leave. First of all, would you please join me one more time in expressing our great thanksgiving to all of our young people who are involved as ministers, as well as the adults who minister tonight. That's all. Word of thanks to all who joined us tonight. Please know you are always welcome. We invite you to join us for our weekend liturgies, 4 p.m. in New Regal, 5:30 in Bastum, 8 o'clock in Liberty on Sunday morning, and 10 o'clock in New Regal on Sunday morning. So please do join us this coming weekend if you're still in town and still around. We'd love to have you with us. Also, a reminder that January 1st is a holy day of obligation. Our holy day masses schedule will be at 4 p.m. in New Regal on Wednesday, New Year's Eve, at 5:30 in Bastum on Wednesday evening, New Year's Eve, and at 9 a.m. here in New Regal on January 1st on New Year's Day. So please do join us then as well. Also, we do offer from all of us at All Saints Patrick and Andrew and at All Saints, from our whole staff, all the deacons, all the staff, we extend to you and to your families a most blessed holiday. We're so glad you're with us. We extend prayers and blessings for safe travels for all of you who must travel yet. So just a word of thanks for your being with us tonight. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Our masses, let us go with peace.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, Joy to the World, found on page 8 of your program.